Okay, so I guess first of all, there were people who'll be surprised that you picked to do like a French art house movie when I'm guessing you could probably have your pick of Hollywood things as well. What was it about this project that particularly made you want to do it?
It happened very sweetly. It wasn't through a casting agent or production, or it was through a mutual friend of Leos and mine. And she suggested me to him, and it was just quite random, really. So I was sent the script, which I confess to not fully grasping upon first read. I went to Paris to meet with Leos, and I guess for both of us to see how we were with each other. And he saw something in me that he felt was right for the character, and that was pretty much that. It was very human way to end up in a film.
And and in the press screening yesterday, there was like so many different reactions. There was gasps, there was laughs, there was like shock, disbelief, yeah. All these things. And it's quite difficult to get that reaction these days, I think, especially with a festival crowd. Mm. What was your kind of reaction to seeing the completed film? And was it how you expected it to be?
That should be an easy question to answer, but I was just blown away. I was literally blown away. I came out slightly baffled, but just moved very deeply. Some parts of it were just truly sublime. Like, I just thought, have I ever seen anything that like that? And I can't imagine the world without some of those moments now. They were just so profound. And I've never been to a Cannes screening, so I don't know what reactions are normally like. But apparently the reaction was really good, and at the end, when the applause just kept going for Leos, I was somewhere between doing cartwheels and weeping. It was really one of the most incredible things to witness and to feel. It was crazy.
Is it quite inspiring to be out in like a big international film festival like this, and to be amongst all these really creative people? And does it make you, you know, does it inspire in other areas? And does it?
You've hit the nail on the head. It is inspiring to be around people with the same intention, the same passion. And I just think to get any movie made is like that's a small miracle in itself. So to get brilliant films made, it's like winning the lottery or something. I'm fascinated that how a producer or a director has to really have such tenacity and passion to get something made. So yeah, and you feel that in the air at Cannes. I'm going to get back to the real world tomorrow and be, you know, my head's going to be full of other things, but here at the Cannes Film Festival, yeah, you think, my God, life should just be about films.
And you get to sing as well. They're now starting to build a house next door. You get to sing in the film as well. Did that make it a more comfortable experience for you, because you like this bit, because it's kind of a crazy film, there's crazy stuff going on. Did that make you think, well, this bit I can do, I know this bit, this is fine? Or did it, you know, how did that sort of affect?
I was less anxious about the singing, and Leos recognised that, but he said that's okay. The kind of uncertainty that you might have in other areas, I don't mind that. You know, he just said, trust me. If you trust me, I promise you, she'll be unforgettable. So I went with that. But the singing was, I that was a first for me to sing like that in the scene, to not sing as I would normally sing a song, and to sing as a, not talking singing, but to continue telling the story. So that was, yeah, it wasn't like, oh, I'm acting and then I'm just going to break into song and go through the usual manoeuvres. It was, in its entirety, it was very different for me.
And has it has the experience kind of inspired you to go to want to do some more acting? Has it inspired you to want to go and write something? What has it kind of made you?
It's definitely inspired me to do more acting. Definitely, I loved being on set. I mean, you know, I've been spoiled. It was such a beautiful experience with an amazing director, and you know, the crew were fantastic, and Laos was just so tender with me, and just. It was like I was a delicate little thing, and I felt, I mean, tender's the word that I keep coming back to. Even though you're shooting a film, you're uncomfortable, it's late, it's cold, blah, 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 all the stuff that's normal. But, I think I have been spoilt, but nonetheless, I'd love to do more.
And do you feel you're at a stage of your life now where you've got a good work-life balance and that you can pick and you've got time to pick what you want to do and how you want to do things? Or are you still like sort of caught up in the whole...
Frenzy.
that's a good word, frenzy, yeah.
I am pretty much caught up in the frenzy, and I wish there was more hours in the day and everything. I think I've always been, I just yearn for different experiences. And so this... in a way, seems for some people they see it as completely outside of the box. Yeah, so was recording a murder ballad with Nick Cave. Back in the day, so was leaving Neighbours. Why are you leaving the number one show? Well, I haven't. As much as I am so mainstream, and I've worked very hard to do that, there's the other side of me. There's that other part that feels fulfilled by doing a project like this
and challenging yourself and doing something out of your own comfort box and being able to go off and experience new things.
Off I trotted to Paris. I banned everyone from coming with me. I said, I know you want to be there because this is very exciting, but sorry, you can't come. I need to go on my own. And it was just from the outset, it felt like a liberating experience. Didn't dream that I would end up with the team on the red carpet in Cannes. That's just gone to the kind of another stratosphere as far as I'm concerned.
You're saying about the fact you said that they couldn't come with you, is it also quite liberating to be able to go without, have, you know, to do stuff without, because you must have so many people with you at most times of your life when you're anywhere?
Yeah, usually I do. I mean, if for any kind of, I don't know, I say work as if you know what kind of work I do, but I don't know if you're doing a in the recording studio or making a video. I don't know, I might have my assistant or hair and makeup or my manager. I mean, that's kind of the base. You would be like that. Then if you're doing a project where you need wardrobe and they've got an assistant, people, very easily it becomes a lot of people. And then if I'm on tour, it's 100 people. There's 100 of us going around. So to pack my little bag and go to Paris and not have any of that was a very, just, it was, there was, I didn't hesitate for a second. I mean, people will say, well, I do everything on my own. Why don't you do anything on your own? It's not that I need all of that. That's just how it normally is. So it was great to let go, which meant that when my team, who are with me now, saw the film, they're like, oh my God, that's what you went and did. We had no idea.
That's where you are, that's what you're doing. Is there ever do you ever have times when you can actually turn your phone off, your BlackBerry off, and switch off, or are you always, pretty much always attached?
I would have liked to have my phone last night straight afterwards to be able to, you know, call home or call my boyfriend or do whatever and say, oh my God, that was amazing. But no, I didn't have my phone. But yeah, there's times so I can switch off.
That's, which is good. And will you get to watch any films while you're here, other than obviously your own film?
Sadly, I didn't, and that's a bit annoying. I would have loved to see some films, but another time.
What kind of films do you enjoy? What's your sort of, what's your thing?
I'm really across the board. I can go rom-com, drama, old, my probably my all-time favourite film is Cinema Paradiso. That's the, that would be my go-to. Of course I'm going to be a mess because as soon as I hear the Morricone soundtrack, I'm a goner already. But I like all sorts of films. I think it depends which mood I'm in.
Cool, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I like that with E.T.